up to Ladera Heights, kind of the hood of LA. And Howard Schultz started laughing and said, "Man, I'm a big fan of yours, and I like your basketball prowess." And he was avoiding the question, is what I'm getting at. And Manning said, "Howard, I know you're busy, but would you be interested in bringing a Starbucks to Ladera Heights?" And Howard said, "Oh, Magic, my other phone is ringing. I'm gonna have to take this call, but I'll call you back." 2 weeks later, 2 weeks go by, Howard makes good on his word. He calls Magic back, tries to change the subject, said, "Man, I love the basketball rivalry between the Lakers and the Boston Celtics. I just want to say thank you for bringing so much joy to our country." And Magic's like, "Yeah, but would you be interested in bringing, that's like Ryan, where Ryan? That's what Ryan was doing to me last night. He's like, "Would you be interested in bringing a Starbucks to Ladera Heights?" And Howard said, "You know, Magic, I knew you were going to bring that up. I was trying to get off the phone before you did it. Let me tell you what I learned in the last 2 weeks." I called my marketing team together, and I asked them where Ladera Heights was. They showed me on a map. I asked them, "Would we be interested in opening up a Starbucks in Ladera Heights?" And what my marketing team told me is that if Ladera Heights was just a quarter mile this way, it would hit the trend and the pattern for where we're opening up Starbucks. Like, you just missed it, man. You just missed it. And Matthew said, "I don't understand what you're saying. You say 1/4 mile makes a difference?" Howard Schultz says to Magic, "We did a feasibility study, and the demographics of the typical profile of a Starbucks drinker doesn't look the same 1/4 mile than it does where our growth pattern is." Magic, like, "Can you translate that?" Howard said, "Magic, off the record, my team is telling me black people don't drink coffee." This is, now y'all can't say I said that, because all this off the record. Control of that.
You can't live stream, but yes. I have control of the footage, but you can't live stream.
Okay, this has just become a hypothetical.
Magic's watching right now.
This is a hypothetical story. So, Magic, without missing a beat, to Howard Schultz said, "Come to LA." Howard said, "All right, I'll look you up when I come to LA." A few months go by, Howard Schultz is in LA. Magic takes him to the Sony Theater in South Central, in Crenshaw, LA, to the hood. And they go to the Magic Johnson Sony Theater, and they walk in, they take 2 steps in the theater, and Magic points to the concession stand. And he's like, "Howard, what do you see?" Howard said, "I see a whole lot of black people." And Magic said, "What are they doing?" Howard said, "They buying popcorn and drinking soda and eating Raisinets." Magic said, "My point is, if you bring a Starbucks to our community, I can prove to you that black people will drink coffee." Howard said, "That's a great proposition. Magic, it costs us $1 million to open up and build a brand new store." Howard Schultz says to Magic, "I'll put up $500,000, and you can put up $500,000. We can find out together whether black people drink coffee or not." Magic paused for a moment on that. Said, "Okay, I'm game." Howard said, "I gotta mitigate the risk. If you take half the risk and I take half the risk, we can find out together whether or not black people drink coffee." Magic took a deep breath, said, "I'm in." Howard said, "One more thing you need to know. Starbucks will focus on the business operation, because that's what we do well. And Magic, you focus on the community that you know best, and let's play to our strength, and we'll find out whether or not black people drink coffee together." Normally, y'all know the profit margin for Starbucks is not like this. It's big. Y'all pay like $4 for something that costs them 40 cents. That's a big profit margin. Normally, it takes 4 years for Starbucks to get its return on this investment, which is pretty quick. 4 years, they get all their money back, and then after that, it's all profit. Y'all follow me? 6 months go by. Howard Schultz calls Magic. to Magic, I got good news and I got bad news. Magic said, give me the bad news first. Howard said, the bad news is that in 6 months, we got all our money back in this Ladera Heights Starbucks. Wow. 6 months, we get all our money back. He goes, what's the bad news? The bad news is no bad news. It's just good news. We're going to open up 100 more stores around the country because I'm thoroughly convinced that black people dream about it. Is we want the same thing in our communities that every other community wants. We want safe streets, we want good schools, we want business opportunities. But if you don't put a Starbucks in our community, how are we going to demonstrate to you that the profile of a Starbucks drinker is much broader than just the profile of your hoity-toity neighborhoods if you don't give us a chance? And when you give us a chance, our market, $1 trillion, a buying power that we have in our market, that is a very powerful voice. And I think Magic deserves to be applauded for getting Starbucks to open Starbucks in urban communities.